morning, everybody. I am B. Ramadevi, Technical Department Mathematics from St. Martin's Engineering College. Today, I am going to explain about evaluation of infinite integrals by using beta and gamma functions. So, first of all, I am going to discuss about the first topic to show that integration 0 to pi by 2 sin to the power of m theta cos to the power of n theta d theta value is equivalent to 1 by 2 times of beta of m plus 1 by 2 comma n plus 1 by 2. By using beta function, I am going to explain about what is the value of integration 0 to pi by 2 sin to the power of m theta cos to the power of n theta d theta is equal to 1 by 2 into beta of n plus 1 by 2 comma n plus 1 by 2. To prove this value, we need beta function definition. So what is beta function definition? We know that beta of m comma n is equal to integration 0 to 1 x to the power of m minus 1 1 minus x to the power of n minus 1 dx. For m greater than 0 comma n greater than 0, let us denote equation number 1. Okay, so now to prove this, I am going to take RHS of the given. What is the RHS? Beta of m plus 1 by 2 comma n plus 1 by 2 value. Using beta definition, replace m by n plus 1 by 2, n by n plus 1 by 2 is equal to integration 0 to 1 x to the power, replace m by n plus 1 by 2. It becomes m plus 1 by 2 minus 1, 1 minus x whole to the power of n plus 1 by 2 minus 1 into dx. Now, which is nothing but x to the power of m plus 1 minus 2 by 2. Okay, so integration 0 to pi by 2, sorry, integration 0 to 1, x to the power of m plus 1 minus 2 by 2, 1 minus x to the power of n plus 1 minus 2 by 2 dx. Simplifying this value, we get x to the power m plus 1 minus 2 is nothing but m minus 1 by 2. In the same way, 1 minus x to the power of n plus 1 minus 2 is n minus 1 by 2 dx. Now, to find out the value of x to the power of n minus 1 by 2, 1 minus x to the power of n minus 1 by 2, I am taking the substitution for x value. Put x is equal to sin square theta. Okay, so differentiation on both sides, we get dx equal to 2 sin theta cos theta d theta. Here sin square theta differentiation is 2 into sin theta. Sin theta differentiation is cos theta. Theta differentiation is d theta. Now, dx keyword. Now, change of limits. Here the limits from x equal to 0 to 1 are there. So we have to change the limits. So x, when x is equal to 0, see here x is equal to sin square theta. So replace x as 0, we get theta is equal to 0 degrees. And for x is equal to 1, replace x as 1, this is sin square theta. So for theta is equal to pi by 2, then only it is possible. So our change of limits becomes x 0, 1, theta 0 to pi by 2. Now substitute all above values in the above equation, that is beta m plus 1 by 2 comma n plus 1 by 2 value becomes, therefore, substitute above values in equation number 2. We get equation 2 LHS is beta of n plus 1 by 2 comma n plus 1 by 2, which is equal to integration 0 to 1 becomes integration 0 to pi by 2. X power m minus 1 by 2 becomes x is here sine square theta. So after substituting x value, it becomes sine square theta to the power m minus 1 by 2 into 1 minus x. So from this we can note down what is 1 minus x. 1 minus sine square theta, which is nothing but cos square theta. So replace in the case of 1 minus cos theta, sine square theta, cos square theta, it becomes cos square theta to the power n minus 1 by 2. What is dx? From this, dx value becomes 2 into sine theta, cos theta, d theta, which is equal to integration 0 to pi by 2. 2 is a constant write down outside. Sine to the power square, so it becomes m minus 1, sine to the power of m minus 1 theta, and here cos to the power of m minus 1 theta, and it remains sine theta and cos theta d theta. So sine theta is nothing but sine power 1 theta, cos theta is nothing but cos power 1 theta. So finally it is 2 times integration 0 to pi by 2, sine power m minus 1 into sine theta is sine to the power of m theta. Cos power n minus 1 into cos is cos to the power of n theta d theta. So therefore theta of m plus 1 by 2 comma n plus 1 by 2, 1 by 2 times of beta of n plus 1 by 2 comma n plus 1 by 2 is nothing but 0 to pi by 2 sine power m theta cos power n theta d theta. So this is the resultant value. So once again, how to show that integration 0 to pi by 2 sine power m theta cos power m theta d theta is equal to 1 by 2 beta of n plus 1 by 2 comma n plus 1 by 2. Okay, first of all use beta definition here. So what is beta definition? Beta of n comma n is equal to integration 0 to 1 x power m minus 1 into 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 dx. For m greater than 0, n greater than 0. Substituting, so taking RHS value here, beta of m plus 1 by 2 comma n plus 1 by 2. Using beta function, replace m by n plus 1 by 2, n by n plus 1 by 2. So after substituting these values, we get integration 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 1 by 2, 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 by 2 dx. Okay, converting this integration part into sine cos. So take the substitution as x equal to sine square theta. So differentiating on both sides, we get dx value. So after that, find out 1 minus x value. So change of limits becomes x is 0, it becomes theta is 0. When x is equal to 1, theta becomes pi by 2. Substitute all these values in the equation 2 so that we can find out beta of m plus 1 by 2, n plus 1 by 2 value is 2 times integration 0 to pi by 2, sine power n theta, cos power n theta, d theta. So therefore finally, we can find out integration 0 to pi by 2, sine power n theta, cos power n theta, d theta value is nothing but 1 by 2 into beta of n plus 1 by 2 comma n plus 1 by 2. Okay. Now, by using this concept, I am going to explain one problem based on, so that is, pi by 2 sine power 5 theta d theta. So how to evaluate integration 0 to pi by 2 sine power of 5 theta d theta. So first of all, write down the given integration 0 to pi by 2 sine power of 5 theta d theta, which is of the form integration 0 to pi by 2 sin to the power of m theta cos to the power of n theta d theta. Now compare the values of m and n here. See, here there is no cos term. Therefore, here we get m value is equal to 5 and n value is equal to 0. Now we have integration 0 to pi by 2. Okay, sine to the power of m theta cos to the power of n theta d theta value is 1 by 2 into beta of m plus 1 by 2 comma n plus 1 by 2. So substitute this m and n in this equation. So 0 to pi by 2 sine to the power of 5 theta d theta can be written as, from equation number 1, replace m by 5, n by 0, substituting 1 by 2 beta of m is equal to 5 here. So it becomes 5 plus 1 by 2 comma here n is equal to 0. So 0 plus 1 by 2. So which is 1 by 2 into beta of 5 plus 1 by 2 is 6 by 2. That is 3 comma beta of 3 comma 0 plus 1 by 2 is 1 by 2. So which is beta of 3 comma 1 by 2. Now by using relation between beta and gamma function, we have beta of m comma n gamma of m into gamma of n by gamma of m plus n. Okay, now substitute here this concept. So here m is 3 and n is 1 by 2. So this becomes gamma of 1 by 2 into gamma of 3 into gamma of 1 by 2 by gamma of 3 plus 1 by 2. Okay, now So 1 by, finally the numerator is 2 into root 5 by 2 into gamma 7 by 2 value 15 by 8 into root 5. So 2 gets cancelled, root 5 gets cancelled. Final answer is 8 by 15. So therefore, integration 0 to pi by 2 sine to the power of 5 theta d theta value becomes 8 by 15. Thank you very much.